Hi, welcome to part 2 of the MAP tutorial, Alarm Management. In this video, we'll learn how to implement an alarm management system using MAP and VC4. To connect to a VC4 HMI application, we'll need the component MpAlarmXListUI. Using the MapLink input, we establish the connection to the configuration that we created in part 1 of this tutorial, named gLinkAlarmXCore. We'll enable the component by setting the enable input. So that we have all the structures and variables we need for the HMI application, we'll set up UI Connect. The data type we need for this is simply the name of the component, followed by the name of the input. The next step is to add a VC4 application. What's important here is to select the MAP technology template because it contains ready-made pages for alarm management, as well as a simple way to link the HMI application to our control software. In the configuration, we'll enable a VNC server that we can use to access the HMI application. Now, we have to connect the right data structure in order to link our HMI application to the control program. Under Shared Resources, we have to select Data Sources. If you refresh the list, you can see that the existing connections are now obsolete. We can use the Refactor option to replace the obsolete structure with our own. All the links needed for alarm management are replaced automatically. Once we've applied our changes to the controller, we're ready to test the HMI application. We can access the HMI application using VNC Viewer. Our alarm management system is located on the page identified by the MpAlarmX logo. If we now activate the temperature high alarm, like we did in part 1 of this tutorial, it appears on the HMI screen. Clicking the Acknowledge button acknowledges the user alarm. So, in just a few easy steps, we've taken an alarm management system in software form and created a fully functional user interface for it. Check out part 3 of the alarm management tutorial to find out how to record and display an alarm history. Thanks for watching.